This is Lewis Hart for Boxing Social in association with Empire Fights. Always good to see Denzel Bentley here in Liverpool Street ahead of your fight with Brad Paul's, topping the bill with a magnificent 7 card. Yeah, always good to see you, mate. How are you?
I'm all good, thanks, man. How you been?
All good, mate. And yeah, all the better for seeing you, and all the better for seeing that you have a British title shot once again. Aim to be a 3-time British champion. Actually, I've got a stat for you. I don't think first time to, if you win, obviously first person to do it since Harold Graham in 1988. So a bit of a stat there.
Oh, that's mad. That's a good stat there. I didn't know that. So at least we're making history again. And they're adding the European on it, so there's more, you know, there's more accolades to achieve on December 7th. So I'm happy.
Yeah, absolutely. And as I say, like, you know, you're back in contention, obviously, another British title shot. So it must be something you're excited about, and having the European on it as well. Big fight against Brad Paul's, and one as the, you know, on that almost on that rebuild in a sense. It's a massive fight, as you say.
Yeah, massive fight. Look at the card, man. It just shows you how massive the fight is. So I'm looking forward to it. I'm happy. I'm active. Even if I weren't headlining, I'd have been happy to be on the card and, you know, be active. You know, I get 3 fights this year, and that's good with me. So. There'll be 4 belts on the line by the time, you know, we get to December 7th, and I just got to do a job, man, and make sure I do it well.
You mentioned the card there, and I'm sure it's, I don't know if it's something you really think about, but it's like second time now, obviously, you headline a Magnificent 7 card, obviously the first one being the Heaney fight. Is it always an extra incentive, always nice to know that you're topping the bill with a card that is stacked?
Sometimes, you know, not really. The first time I was like, oh my days, I got this guy on a card, that guy on a card. You had Nick Bull versus Doug Bowl, that was a sick fight. But then I don't get to see none of them anyway, because I'll be getting ready, do you know what I'm saying? So it's just good to know that it's going to be a packed out venue, packed out arena, because of, you know, the magnitude of the card. So yeah, it'll be good to know that I'll be playing in a packed out Wembley.
One thing Frank said there is like, no, it's right for you to say, obviously being number 2 in the WBO, but he said the winner of this, you know, he will get him a world title shot. So obviously big claims for yourself, and as you said, an added incentive that know that, no, Brad Paul's is no monk, but there's a lot of connotations around it.
Yeah, man, he's no monk, but at the end of the day, Frank saying all of that, you know, world title next and all that stuff, that sounds really good, but, you know, December 7th, man, one job, one step at a time, man. December 7th is where I've got to do the business first, and whatever's next from there is next. Like, I don't really care what it is. Just get me active. I want a world title shot at some point, but if that's not next and I know I'm stepping in the right direction, it is what it is, but December 7th, man.
Is that something you learned of, as you say, like one step at a time? As I think we spoke about before, you say you know not to look ahead anymore after what happened previously.
Yeah, 100%, because, I mean, for the Heaney fight, it was all exciting. Like, oh, yeah, world title shot next, yeah, we go. And then you're already looking at who could potentially be fighting next for a world title. And it's like, what's the point? Because if you don't win, you're not fighting anyone. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, you'd be lucky to fight again. So, yeah, man, December 7th.
That's absolutely fair enough. And one thing, you know, when we spoke after the Heaney fight, you always said to me, you know, you said, listen, it's my job to erase sort of them faults or them doubts from any public that may have could of that fight. And it's fair to say, you know, you've done that, knocking out Danny Diggum and knocking out Derek Zaza, and the style that you've done, that was obviously the intention. Did it feel nice? And even after that fight, people were saying, you know, he's probably skipped British level now. I know you're fighting Brad Paul's, and it's for a European title, it's for that. But did it feel a credit to yourself that you have almost erased that in people's memories to show, like, you know, that was an off night in a way? So it must be, you know, you said what you wanted to do and you went out and done it.
Almost, but there's one more step. And that's beating the guy that beat him, beating the guy that beat me. So that's one more step without fighting a Calipi, you know what I'm saying? So without fighting Heaney, beating Brad would finally erase that kind of memory from people's, you know, people's memories or their thoughts or whatever. But yeah, I think I got one more step.
And for yourself, it's clear to see, you know, punch power is definitely not something that you lack. And it's always something that's talked about. And especially when you are getting these knockouts and you're flatlining people like you are, it's easy to get carried away from that. Do you think it's sort of, for yourself, it's important to stay grounded and not, like, fall in love in the power, in a sense, which is always sort of something people say?
Yeah, I think it's important to know where your power comes from. You know, what style of boxing kind of complements your power. And I know what kind of style. I kind of find that style that complements my power. So, it's become more evident than ever that my power is real, just because, you know, I've been fighting the way I need to fight for my power to be effective.
One thing you mentioned there, right, Sam, you sparred Brad Paul's before?
Yeah, we sparred a while back. I sparred him twice, actually. I sparred him before I boxed Morrison and before he boxed Heaney the first time.
Yeah. Is it a bit of a weird one, like, when you're sparring, like, when you're fighting someone, you're sparring, and it obviously is, you know, you're somewhat familiar to him, and it's happened a few times before, like, ever come into your mind? Like, is it ever a weird thing to deal with?
Not anymore, because, I mean, my last 2 opponents, I'd sparred them, especially Danny. I sparred him a lot of times, done a lot of camps together, but it's just one of those things, isn't it? Just end up fighting someone that you used to spar, but I sparred almost everyone in the country in my weight class, so not really. It can. Let me not lie, it can. Because you start thinking, oh, I've done this in sparring, can I do it again? Or he done this to me in sparring, he might be thinking. But, yeah, ultimately, nah.
A final one from myself, and it kind of contradicts what we are talking about in the interview. And I know you're going to shut it down, but it's obviously, it's a name that I'll always mention to yourself, and it's always been mentioned till the day you end up fighting. And it's obviously obviously the name Hamzah Sheeraz. And I know you're highly ranked in WBO, he's highly ranked in WBO. Frank promised him a world title shot. It's yet to be seen where it may be. It may be with Jana Beck at the WBO. I know you're not going to get ahead of yourself, but it must be like, you know, you're going to look forward to Brad Paul's, and that's always something you're going to aim for, but it must be exciting if, you know, let's say Jana Beck is the opponent that, you know, you could be next in line, all goes well on December 7th, that will be an aim, either a Jana Beck rematch or a Sheeraz fight, which are the two names that you ideally want at middleweight.
Yeah, I mean, they're both. I mean, I can't really look at that until whoever he's fighting and gets announced, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know who. It's all well and good guessing and trying to figure out, you know, trying to put puzzles together and all that stuff, but nothing's been confirmed about his opponent, so I can't really look at that. But yeah, whatever you were saying, it does. Yeah, you're right. I mean, irrespective of whether I'm fighting bad or not, whoever wins that world title, it's a tasty fight. I'm saying, whether it's Hamza or Yanabek or whoever the other champions are, it's always going to be a tasty fight. But I'm not really looking at, oh, I can fight this guy and that guy, because whoever he's fighting hasn't even been confirmed yet. So I'm not really paying no interest in that until it gets announced, and then I can look and be like, oh shit, but hopefully my fight will be done by then, and I can really like look into it.
Definitely, for sure. Denzel, always a pleasure, mate. Always good to catch up with you, and all the best. Appreciate it, mate. Top